guys, my name is Peter and welcome to our channel. Today I'd like to share with you guys some experience and my thoughts about Sony PlayStation VR goggles. I own those goggles already for a couple of weeks. Well, I got them as a birthday present. It did come with Gran Turismo VR, Gran Turismo Sport, and actually I was really waiting for that game when it's gonna be released with VR goggles, and that's when I kinda want to buy it. Anyway, the game itself is pretty good. I really like in the VR mode. The VR goggles itself, it has some positives, some negatives things, and if you saw my previous old videos, you know I'm kinda trying to make it the more accurate and the most honest opinion. I mean, all my reviews is not being paid by anyone. All stuff I buying from my own money anyway. Pretty much, I don't have any reason to sugarcoat it anything, or kind of tell you some kind of funny stuff. Anyway, the goggles itself, to be honest, it's pretty comfortable, at least to me. And like I said, it's my own opinion. It can be different from yours, or can be different for somebody else. In my case, I really like it. The goggles itself is not too heavy. To be honest, I was kind of expecting a little bit heavier. It's a 700 gram, it's less than 2 pounds. It's probably a pound and 10 ounces, or a pound 9 ounces or so. Fits in pretty good. I mean, nice. I mean, the rubber seal, it provided a good seal. You can play probably hours without getting tired, but of course, for every people will be different. Here's a button to bring it in and out to seal it closer to your face. Those little buttons, well, kind of looks button, a square, X, zero, and triangle is not a button. Someone probably is gonna try push it. That's not a button. It's just a kind of a logo. Then another thing, like I said. When I own it, usually all my stuff. If I don't like something, I will modify it. And like I said, the goggle feels fits pretty good, but when you play in the standing position, because of all that long cable and the heavy brake box for the two HDMI, plus after that box is going dual HDMI cable, and it's not really flexible. I mean, I don't know why they didn't use it, some kind of like a silicone flexible wires. The wires is kind of hard, plus it's heavy, and when you're playing in a standing position, pretty much that brake box with cables, it will always push, pull it down. What I did on this little controller, on that cable, there's a controller, and the controller kind of simple one. Volume down, volume up, microphone on off, and goggles itself on off. On the back side, and actually on this side also, the microphone. And phone and headphones jack. On the back side of the controller, I attach it. I found it a little plastic clip, I should call. I modify it a little bit, make sure the spring is stronger. It can rotate 360. That case where I'm wearing goggles, pretty much I can clip it to my short, and the cable will not be able to pull it down, like I said, applying pressure on the helmet. That actually it makes more comfortable to play. Then another thing which I did recognize it, the stand, what it comes with camera. I mean, it's I'm not saying it's a crappy and cheesy, no. It's kind of unique one for Sony design. And it's made to be, you can place the camera on top of bezel of your TV, or you can put it under TV. Pretty much when it's going on top of TV itself, I mean, you can bend it. You see it's got three joints. It can bend any direction. The thing is, not every TV come with a nice square shaped bezel. Like a bezel on my TV, the frame itself, I call bezel, it's rounded. Pretty much that stand doesn't stay on the TV itself. It's not staying at all. I have to put it on my entertainment table and just tweak it and then adjust it. it's kind of working, but because the cable is pretty hard, you can see right now. I mean, well, let me push it this way. That case you're not gonna tell me I did pull it by cable. You see, the cable is really hard. You have, when you place it, you have to bend the cable in the right direction, and still sometimes camera moves. When I did unpackage it, my package, first thing I recognized, this end is heavier. It has a couple metals. I believe it's like couple ounces or less than couple ounces additional metal inside. And that tip of end, it's a rubberized. Anyway, in my opinion, the weight is not enough. Or they should rubberize that the whole portion to make sure it's more sticky to the table. Plus, this area, it will be nice. Because if you try to push it, I mean, you can see this one is rubberized and it's stuck. The front end doesn't. That's why the stand is always, I mean, like I said, it's not super stable. Anyway, then another thing. Of course, like, well, I didn't mention it yet, but it comes with bunch of cables. The brake box, or the brain box, it has a 6 connectors, 2 in the front HDMI, 2 in the back HDMI, then micro USB, and power supply. The box itself, it has only 2 little rubber pads. There's no rubber foot. And when you plug it, most likely you're gonna do like I do, leave it right on top of the unit itself. Because if you leave it on the side, and PlayStation 4 has on the side the ventilation holes, you probably will block it, and somehow it's gonna probably affect cooling capability for your PlayStation 4. It's always nice to put it probably on top, or somewhere on the floor, or somewhere next to. But because those two rubber pads pretty small, the system also movable really easy. Plus, that the USB cable, because Sony PlayStation 4 doesn't have any USB on the back side, it have to go and connect it on the front. Pretty much mean you have only one USB left if your controller dying, or both your move sensors batteries start dying and you have to plug it in to charge it. You will have to use it additional those little chargers, or you charge it one at a time because you have only one port available. Then brain box has a power supply. I was gonna show you. And I don't know why Sony stick with that idea. Is it like power supply, then additional power cable? In my opinion, and the power supply is a 12 volts, 3 amp, which kind of okay. In my opinion, they should use those kind of style power supplies. And they do have in a 3 amp array. It's a little bit bigger than the one I'm holding in my hand. But in that case, I mean, you're losing one additional cable already. Because when you're receiving VR goggles in this box, it comes with a bunch of cables, some instructions, which to hook it up, I mean, don't get me wrong, it's pretty simple. It's pretty straightforward. You don't have to be rocket scientist to hook it up. The brain box, I mean all wires, and make it run. It takes you probably a couple minutes. Some people say, oh, it's too many wires, quite complicated. In my opinion, it's not really. It's pretty simple. Anyway, well, like I mentioned, on the one hand, it's pretty good goggles. I mean, VR goggles. A few things which are kind of disappointing when I discovered it. The system itself, the way it's producing image, before I bought actually, I thought it had 2 individual screens inside, like maybe a square inch or so, I mean for each eye. And it turns actually it has, Sony did go, I'm not saying it's a cheaper way, or I'm not saying it's a worse way or so. Anyway, they're using a one big 5.7 organic LED OLED. With resolution 1920 by 1080. And that's when I saw the specs, I thought 1920 by 1080 is for each eye. And actually it turns for each eye, this goggles has 960 by 1080. it's equal to close to or so around 720p, not 1080p. And a lot of people saying, well, when you play and you see all those skin lines between the crystals, I mean the pixels, I'm sorry, and it kind of drive you nuts. To be honest, if you really picky, you know, and that's going to be bothering you, it's one thing. For me, I know it's there, I just get used to and I accept it the way it is. Well, the final verdict, I mean, for $300, if it's really worth it. In my opinion, I mean, well, it did come with a game, and the game which I really wanted. The game itself, it's $60 or $70, I believe, or so. Which, pretty much the helmet itself, I mean, that goggles made $240 or so. It's kind of a good deal. It's kind of a good deal, plus I got as a birthday present, there's no way I can complain. Yeah. But like I said, it has a lot of good things, a lot of negative things about the helmet. I mean, about that goggles, I still call helmet. And the games, I mean, we tried a few games already, lots of demos we tried, and I do like it. Like I said, it will not work for everybody. That's why since October 2007, it's slightly over 2 million being sold VR goggles. Not much. If you compare it for last, what, 3.5 years or so, over 40 million PS4 being sold, it make a huge difference. Anyway, I'd like to see how far Sony will take VR goggles. Plus, I'd like to see what next model will be. I'm pretty sure it will be lighter, probably. It will be better resolution. And I hope that all those wire mess, that's gonna make something smaller. Maybe the brain box will be in the helmet, in the goggles itself, only one HDMI cable instead two. That big nasty brick box is kind of joke. I don't know why they use it full size HDMI instead. I mean mini HDMI. I'm not saying micro HDMI. Even micro HDMI too fragile. Mini HDMI will work probably the best. Well, I hope guys you do like this video. If you do, thumbs up. And if you don't want to miss any future videos, subscribe, we'll really appreciate it. Thank you and have a great day. Bye-bye.